On behalf of the students, faculty, and staff of East Georgia State College, welcome to our Fall 2020 Commencement. East Georgia State College is a special place, and you are a special community devoted to assuring that every student in our region has the opportunity to achieve their dreams. Thank you for participating in this celebration of the amazing students who have had the tenacity and dedication to take full advantage of the opportunities presented to them. We are proud that some of our graduates have served in the military or are now serving. We know that some of you as well have served in the military. We deeply appreciate the service of all of you. Graduates, few days as special as this one take place in a lifetime. As we begin this momentous ceremony, breathe deeply and enjoy this moment that you have earned. Quickly recall a special learning moment at East Georgia State College. Smile and commit that moment to memory. Silently commit to say thank you today to all those who helped you achieve. Tonight, dream in vivid colors about the exciting future that awaits you. Families and supporters of the graduates, earning a college degree is a hard thing to do. Currently, only about 1/3 of adults in the United States achieve a college degree. As you participate in this ceremony, you deserve to take great pride in your graduate as they enter the Academy of Scholars. These graduates have the opportunity to celebrate today because of the high expectations that you set for them, the countless hours you spent with them, and the love and support you gave them so generously. You are the best. Graduates, this graduation ceremony is called a commencement because it is a beginning, the beginning of a lifetime of opportunities available to you. Because you had the tenacity and did the hard work necessary to earn a college degree, my dream for you is that this diploma will lead to a lifetime of success. But it is not my dream for you which is important. It is the unique and special dream of success which each of you holds in your own heart and mind that is really important. Graduates, define success on your own terms. You will never attain the happiness and satisfaction which success brings if you are chasing someone else's dream. So, Fall 2020 graduates, as you prepare to start that new job, move on to another college for an advanced degree, or take whatever you have chosen as your next step in life, please think long and hard about what is truly important to you, how you define your own success. Go get that done. Have confidence that everyone participating in this ceremony today will be standing in the wings, watching and waiting to help you as you soar. Congratulations, graduates. Morgan and Megan Bryant will now sing God Bless America. Immediately following God Bless America, Kevin Hunter will deliver our reflection. Twin sisters, Megan and Morgan Bryant, are from Reidsville, Georgia. Their parents are Phyllis Gaffney and George Brown. Known around campus for their singing talent, they are sometimes referred to as the singing twins or the dynamic duo. Megan is a nursing major and would one day like to be a neonatal nurse. She plans to attend Ogeechee Technical College to obtain her LPN following graduation. Morgan is currently serving as president for the African American Union on the Swainsboro campus of East Georgia State College. She is majoring in criminal justice. Megan and Morgan have honored us during their time at East Georgia by singing at so many events. Since they are both graduating today, this will be the last time we will have the opportunity to have them perform for us. We will miss you so much, Megan and Morgan. Both of these young women have asked me to express their thanks to East Georgia State College for making their experience here feel like being part of one big family. Kevin Hunter is from Valdosta, Georgia, and is an EGSC student at our Statesboro campus. Since joining the East Georgia State College student body in 2019, he has been actively involved in all parts of student life. Kevin is a member of the African American Male Initiative. He also serves as vice president of the Student Government Association. In his spare time, Kevin likes to work out, go to the range, and play football. As a criminal justice major, Kevin plans to continue his education by going to Georgia Southern University after he graduates from East Georgia to complete his bachelor's degree. Following graduation from Georgia Southern University, Kevin will be commissioned in the Army as a second lieutenant. His goal is to one day work as a field agent for the FBI. And now, Morgan and Megan Bryant, followed by Kevin Hunter.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies, from the why we fall. God bless America, my home sweet home. From the mountains to the prairies, from the oceans why we fall. God bless America, my home sweet home. From the mountains to the prairies, from the ocean's waterfall. God bless America,
Good morning. We can make it through this difficult dispensation of time. Even though COVID-19 has changed reality, what it has not changed is our perseverance. I must admit, it is challenging and difficult at times to embrace the new normal, and we all at times may feel like giving up. However, purpose and destiny await our arrival, and we will not stop until we've reached our destined place. I would like to leave you with a very powerful scripture that empowers me daily. This verse provides me with the strength and motivation I need to push through each day. I leave you with this scripture: even youths shall faint and be weary, and young men shall fall exhausted. But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Isaiah 40, verses 30 through 31.
Thank you, Megan and Morgan and Kevin. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce our alumni speaker, Alexandra Rios. Currently, Alex is the bilingual multimedia journalist reporter at NBC Right Now in Kennewick, Washington. As a journalist and photographer, Alex uses her camera as a tool to help the world understand the experience of minorities in the United States. Alex graduated from the University of Georgia Grady College of Journalism and Mass Communication in 2019. She was a multimedia intern at the UGA Office of Sustainability, a bilingual multimedia journalist at UGA Grady News Source, a digital journalist at UGA Grady Mobile News Lab, and a visual journalist at UGA's photojournalism department. She was also a multimedia journalist intern at WALB 10 News. Alex served as the UGA Vice President of National Hispanic Journalist Association, UGA Social Media Coordinator of National Press Photographers Association, and Director of Social Media Assistant of Digigamma Kappa Professional Broadcast Society. Prior to transferring to UGA, Alex was a Correll Scholar at East Georgia State College and a 2017 cum laude graduate with an Associate of Arts in Communication Arts and an ambassador for the college. As an ambassador, Alex was very involved in every aspect of student life. We are so proud to say that Alex is originally from Swainsboro and aspires to be an international reporter.
It is an honor to be here with you today, and it is my pleasure to welcome all graduates, family, EGSC professors, staff, and faculty to graduation day at East Georgia State College. Every one of you have made an impact on the graduates who made it here today. 3 years ago, I remember being in the exact position you are currently in, eager to receive my EGSC diploma and excited about what was to come. After graduation, in fact, my excitement for graduation was all the more special because I knew I was a few moments away from becoming a first-generation college student. For those of you who don't know what being a first-gen means, it is whenever one is the first in their families to graduate from college ever. And so if this applies to you today, I want you to be especially proud of yourself. You've all earned it. My parents, who are originally from Mexico, wanted nothing more than to see their kids succeed in life. They left everything behind to start a new life in small town America. My dad saw an opportunity to have a better life for our family, so he took it. I can only imagine how nervous my father must have been about moving his family to a foreign country where he knew little to no English, for the next to nothing about the American culture. Yet, they did it anyways, and along the way, Swainsboro became our family home. My dad always told me it didn't matter what I did or what I became later in life. He just encouraged me to do something and to do it well. Like most girls during the ages of 12 and 13, I originally wanted to be the next Hannah Montana. But as you can see, that didn't happen. And while I could spend the rest of my time talking about all the reasons I would have been a great Hannah Montana, I'd rather try and share some useful perspectives to help you navigate the early parts of your careers after college. Here's my first piece of advice. Be resourceful. By learning to work with what you have instead of letting what you wish you could have get in the way of your growth. Now that I'm working as a full-time TV journalist, I can easily think back to the moments where I wish I would have gotten the best shot or the best interview or even the newest equipment. But those thoughts don't get very far. Instead, I ground myself by thinking about how blessed I am to even be in the United States chasing my career goals and passion. Perspective matters. Next piece of advice I want to share, pursue what makes you happy. After graduating from East Georgia State College, I almost pursued nursing because I thought that's what I was supposed to do in order to be successful. Had I pursued nursing, I would have even had the benefit of graduating with no student loans. But I'm grateful for my mentors who helped me realize early on that money isn't everything. They also taught me that life is too short and complicated to spend it doing something that doesn't bring you genuine joy and excitement every day. So with that in mind, I pursued my passion for journalism at one of the top journalism programs in the country, at the University of Georgia's Grady College, something I have dreamed of shortly after I realized my voice wasn't going to cut it for a role like Hannah Montana. During my time in college, I knew that if I was going to get into the industry, it was all up to me. I didn't have anyone in my family or didn't even know of anyone in the career I wanted to pursue. So I did everything I could to be involved with like-minded people. When I wasn't in class, I attended seminars and workshops to hear tips and tricks on how working professional journalists got their break. I volunteered for hours working behind the cameras as a production crew member to see how the industry works. The same way people binge watch Atlanta Housewives, I would watch videos on YouTube to learn everything I could about reporter reels. Became close friends with my professors. Every opportunity that came my way, just like my parents, I said yes. As graduation was approaching, I didn't want to graduate without a job. I did not want to be unemployed and move back in with my parents, even though I'm sure they would have welcomed me back with open arms. My parents had already done so much for me to get me through school, and I had already committed so much time and energy into my studies, I couldn't afford to be unemployed because of the opportunities and networks I focused on created during my time in college. Many opportunities began to present themselves to me. After posting my work online, I began to be recruited by several TV stations across the country, including two in Georgia. 10 months after graduating from UGA, I am 2,628 miles away from home in the state of Washington, working as a morning news reporter at NBC right now. So here's my last piece of advice, and hopefully this will stick with you. I'm here to tell you to not be afraid of change. I hope you constantly choose to be in situations that make you feel uncomfortable and that challenge you, because if you aren't being challenged, it's not changing you. Trust me, moving to Washington, not only not knowing what it could have been like, not knowing not even a single person on this side of the country, may have been the craziest thing I've done so far, but it's also been one of the best decisions I've ever made because what I get to do every day on the job. I wake up every morning at 2 a.m. to tell people the morning news on live TV. Despite how challenging the job sometimes, I can say with confidence that I finally did it. And it would have not been possible without my parents and the values they taught me of hard work and resilience. Everything I am is because of them, and I will always be extremely grateful for the sacrifices they've made for me and my family. I believe you are also here at this moment because someone in your life made it possible for you to be here. Someone believed in you even when you may have not believed in yourself. So after this graduation ceremony, I encourage you to hug your parents or guardians a little bit tighter, or maybe not because of COVID restrictions. Just make sure you celebrate the contributions other people have played in your life that have led you to where you are today. Thank you to our parents, family, and friends, mentors, and professors, because without your contributions to our life, this day would have never happened the way it has. Congratulations to the class of 2020. You did it.
Thank you, Alex. Our student representative today is Student Government Association President Precious Coleman. Precious is from Eastman, Georgia, and her parents are Derek Coleman and Pamela Clark. Precious is a member of the Spring 2021 graduating class of East Georgia State College. She is majoring in criminal justice. In addition to serving as SGA president, Precious is also an active member of the African American Union, as well as a member of the Criminal Justice Club. Following graduation from EGSC, Precious plans to attend Mercer University to pursue her bachelor's degree in information technology with a minor in data analytics. Precious has a daily quote by Reginald Lewis that she lives by: keep going no matter what.
Good afternoon, Dr. Bomer, faculty, staff, family, friends, and graduates. I would like to thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak to the graduating class of 2020. Before getting into my speech, I would like to give honor to God, who is ahead of my life, and to everyone in their respectable places. My first point is simple: keep God first. You are often told to put God first, but I want to express how important it is to keep God first. We like to thank God for the good, but we tend to forget that He was there through the bad as well. Appreciate what God has brought you through, because that same journey is why you are here today. God is here to protect and direct your path. Robert Shirley once said, "Failure does not mean you are a failure. It simply just means you haven't succeeded yet." Which brings me to my second point: don't be afraid to fail. I'll be the first to tell you that you are going to fail, and fail again, and fail again, and fail again. In fact, you are probably going to fail 100 times before you are able to succeed. And yes, it is going to hurt. But how you choose to proceed with the outcomes of those failures will determine the next step for you. If I can encourage you to remember anything I say today, remember this: do not become content with any success you obtain, but to always keep a hunger for more success and growth in life. In the words of the late, great Muhammad Ali, "A man who looks at the world when he is 50, the same way he looks at it when he was 20, and it hasn't changed, he has wasted nearly 30 years of his life." You all came here with a purpose. However, graduating is only a portion of that battle. The fight has only just begun. From this day forward, push yourself towards a greater goal. Even when you feel you have nothing left, keep fighting. I challenge you all to help, to create, to inspire, to innovate, and to change lives for the better. Again, I say congratulations to you all. Now it is time to fulfill the next chapter in your life.
Thank you, Precious. East Georgia State College is privileged to have Dr. George Frederick as this morning's commencement speaker. A native of Fairfax, South Carolina, Dr. Frederick was commissioned as a distinguished military graduate from Texas State University as an infantryman in 1987 with a bachelor's of science degree in political science. Dr. Frederick also holds two master's degrees: a master's of military art and science from Fort Leavenworth School of Advanced Military Studies, and a master's in personnel administration from Central Michigan University. In addition, he holds a specialist in educational administration degree from Columbus State University and a doctorate in educational leadership from Georgia Southern University. Dr. Frederick's military education includes completion of the Infantry Officers Basic and Advanced Courses, the Army Command and General Staff College, School of Military Advanced Studies, Joint and Combined Warfighting School, Ranger School, Airborne School, and Air Assault School. Dr. Frederick understands the unique mission of this college. In addition to his numerous other degrees, he is a graduate of Central Texas College. At the time of his graduation, Central Texas College was a community college. Prior to becoming Director of Military and Veterans Affairs in February of this year at Georgia Southern University, Dr. Frederick was the scholarship and enrollment officer for Army ROTC at Georgia Southern University. In this position, he developed and continued to implement a recruitment strategy that directly contributed to meeting and surpassing recruiting mission requirements. He designed, developed, and wrote Army ROTC recruiting promotional videos for Army ROTC recruiting in the state of Georgia. And he was responsible for identifying, recruiting, and retaining the highest quality cadets for the nation and the Army. Early in his career at Georgia Southern University, Dr. Frederick was a professor of military science. Under his leadership, he transformed an ROTC program that was already doing well into a program that was nationally ranked as one of the top 8 programs in the nation. The program received the first MacArthur Award and continued to receive the award in 2009, 2010, 2015, and 2016. He is a recipient of the Bronze Star Medal, Defense Meritorious Service Medal, Meritorious Service Medal, Joint Service Achievement Medal, Army Achievement Medal, Army Good Conduct Medal, Armed Forces Expeditionary Medal, Humanitarian Service Award, and the Korean Service Medal. Serving as ROTC Battalion Commander and U.S. Army Officer at Georgia Southern University, Dr. Frederick was promoted to the rank of Colonel in April 2011. Dr. Frederick is affectionately known by his colleagues, students, and friends as Colonel Fred. Thank you, Colonel Fred, for honoring us with your presence today.
Good morning. Dr. Bomer, sir, I want to extend my thanks to you for extending this invitation to me. But on behalf of many, I'd like to thank you for your 8 years of leadership at this awesome institution. Best of luck to you and the wife, and spoil those grandchildren in the future. To the East Georgia State College senior leadership, I want to say thank you for this opportunity to come and make some remarks today. And a special thanks to Miss Angie, Miss Harley, and I call him Noah K., the best dressed man in all of Southeast Georgia. Faculty, staff, students, family members of the May 2020, summer 2020, fall 2020 graduation. Congratulations to all the moms, the dads, the uncles, the aunties, the grandmas, the significant others, because you played a pivotal role in the success of the day. This is a family affair. And I did my research. I was told that these are lively events, these kind of ceremonies at East Georgia State College. I'm told people are happy, people are crying, people are dancing, and I hope you're doing that in your homes today. To the graduates, I just want to say, congratulations. Congratulations. However, you're not done yet. I'm going to be mindful of your time because you're sequestered away with your family and you got a whole bunch of other things to do other than listen to some old guy talk. So I will adhere to the 5 B's of public speaking. Be brief, brother, be brief. I want to begin by giving some context of this senior class. I'm told there are about 176 graduates. Nearly a 3.0 GPA. I'm told that 75% of this class are traditional students, and only 25% of the class are non-traditional students, age 25 and above. And I want to give a special shout out to Ms. Yolanda and Ms. Courtney. I'm not going to tell their ages, but I know that they're north of 50. And for you to achieve your degree this day, this year, sends a strong testimony to not only your family, but your friends and to many others. That is an example of lifetime learning. This class is very diverse. American Indian, Asians, African Americans, Hispanics, Caucasians, and multiracials. Multiracial. We look like America. Graduating class, you thrived, you excelled, you achieved in spite of COVID-19, and we're very proud of you. My disclosures up front, I want you to know that prior to making these remarks, I spoke to the student government leaders twice. I had 2 Zoom meetings, so anything that you wanted to hear that you do not hear is their fault, and anything that I say that you did not want to hear, it is their fault. No, that was a joke. I just want to say a special shout out to Sanjay, Precious, Brandon, Elijah, Andrew, Lundy, and Brandon. A great group of leaders, and it sounds like I'm going to see all of them, or most of them, at Georgia Southern University in the future. I'm still working on Lundy. At this point in your life, I want you to be thinking about your dreams. I want you to dream big. I want you to reach for the moon, and if you land on the stars, you're going to be okay. No small dreams. Dreams and goals are important, and at this point in your life, you need to have them down. If you need help, come find me. I'll help you write them down, and we'll come up with a plan together. It's important to me that you have big dreams, and you will find out why in a little bit. Graduates, you're on a journey. As I said before, this is not the end all. This is just a start. When you look across the world, less than 8% of the people in the world have an undergraduate degree. Here in America, only 33% of Americans have an undergraduate degree. Graduates, I want you on this third. I don't want you on that two-thirds. Because when you obtain that, you obtain flexibility. You obtain options for your life. You get the opportunity to make more money. You get the opportunity to contribute more to my future Social Security. I'm depending on you. To reach your dreams, your goals, it's not going to be easy, but you can do it. You have no other choice. People are depending upon you. Now, how do you do this? Simply, just stay connected. I want you to stay connected to your faith. I want you to stay connected to yourself and your health, and I want you to stay connected to your money. I have had the blessing of living long enough to understand life to the degree that storms will come, storms will go. But those that are anchored in faith will always hold on. Those that not will blow with the storm. And when the storm leaves, they'll be somewhere else. And it's very difficult for them to get back on path for their dreams and their goals. But those that hold on to that faith and get through that storm, they come out stronger on the other end. Stay connected to your faith. Graduates, I want you to stay connected to your health. I want you to start right now to eat right. Develop an exercise regimen that works for you. You don't have to run the Boston Marathon. You don't have to lift 3,000 pounds, but you need to find something that's going to keep your body healthy. I want you to also caution how much stuff we put in here. Put good stuff in here. Minimize some of the social media, some of the junk, because when you put it in you, that's what you become. And I want you to start now. Continue to be a lifelong learner. I want you to stay connected to your learning. As I stated before, this is only a stop on the way of the journey. I want you to earn that undergraduate degree at Georgia Southern University. I want you to get more certificates. I want you to get master's degrees, specialist degrees, doctoral degrees. You can do it, and these are the best investments for you. I want you to stay connected to your family. COVID-19 has taught us a lot. We were locked down at home with our families. For some of us, that was a blessing. For others, outcome may not have been the same. But as I look down the road for your future, I want you to work on those relationships. I want you to build those relationships, because in the end, that's all you have is your family. Stay connected to your family. And finally, I want you to stay connected to your money. And what am I talking about? We're college students now. We don't make high incomes. One day you will. But the time to prepare for that is now. I want you to understand that you're not Congress. You can't spend more than you make. I want you to understand to live on less than you make. I want you to learn now how to save, how to invest, and God knows how to give. Because there's one secret about money that people don't advertise enough. It's called compound interest. Money times time equals more money. I say that again. Money times time equals more money. And I want you to dream big. I want you to have dreams that says at 51 years old, I got $300 sitting in the bank and I don't have a mortgage payment. I want you to dream big now. I listened to a guy called Les Brown, noted author and speaker. I think his nickname is The Motivator. Check him out sometime. His story is definitely a great one. He was born with a twin brother and abandoned. A young lady in Liberty City, Florida, which is not the best part of Miami, adopted him. Although fatherless, but motherful by that young lady. Les grew up, worked hard. Les became a big-time radio disc jockey in Columbus, Ohio. Les got fired. Les got motivated. He ran for Congress. He won a term. He's had some ups and downs, and I think most recently he's been battling cancer. But he tells two stories that stick with me and I think is appropriate for you, because I'm looking at you down in the future. One is Les says that some of the best dreams in the world, the richest place in the world to find the best dreams in the world, is the cemetery. Some of those people took those dreams and those goals with them, rather than cure cancer, rather than become presidents, rather than become governors, CEOs, teachers, pastors, firemen, police officers. Some of those people took their dreams and their goals with them. Don't you do that. Don't you do that. Get after it. Leave it all on the field. Reach for the moon and land on the stars. Les also tells a story, and I think he borrowed this from somebody else. There's an elderly gentleman in the hospital. He's on his deathbed. The doctors and the nurses told him a matter of hours or days, and they walked out. The older gentleman collected himself, kind of shed his eyes. I guess he said a prayer, and he opened his eyes and he looked around the bed, and there were some images. And one of them was vision. One of them was his goals. And one of them was his talents. And all three of those images were sitting there, and they were like this. And the old man said, what? And they told him, you never used us. And the old man said, whoa, wait a minute. Let me pass you to my children. Let me give you to my friends. Let me pass you to my relatives. And all of them said, no. Because you fail to develop us, we're going to that grave with you. Graduating class of 2020 for East Georgia State College, that will not be you. I thank you for your time. May God continue to bless you, and may God continue to bless the United States of America.
Dr. Sandra Sharman, Vice President for Academic and Student Affairs, will now present the degree candidates.
President Bomer, these candidates have completed all the coursework required for their degree of Associate in Arts, Associate of Science, Bachelor of Arts in Fire and Emergency Services Administration, Bachelor of Science in Biology, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, and the Choice Certificate of Accomplishment in Work Readiness Skills, and have been approved by the faculty. It is my distinct pleasure to present them to you for the conferring of their degree and certificate. Abriana Ahrens, Cassidy J. Aiken, Salamak Alimu, Kiera Blackburn, Teresa J. Blunt, Bria Boyer, cum laude, Hallie Brown, Amaya Brown, Jerry Z. Brown. Morgan K. Bryant. Megan Bryant. Shaya Buckley. Hunter Carter. Alyssa Chalker. Destiny Kofer. Ashley Danily. Jada Darasaw, magna cum laude. Logan Davidson, cum laude. Shanisha Davis. Sitlali Escamilla, magna cum laude. Destiny Ford. Charisse Ford. Rihanna Fort. Maggie L. Franklin. Daliandra Gordon. John Michael Harper. Tara G. Hayslip, cum laude. Jasmine Hurd. Alexis Hurd. Garion Henry. Chandrika Hill. Patrick E. Hudson. Haley M. Hutchison. Zion E. Johnson. Rajanique Lane. Kirsten T. Leeks. Andrew T. Lester. Sabanjil Mahangu. Ashley McKinney, cum laude. Keisha Moment. Julia Moore. Brinkley Moss. Michaela Nelson. Aaliyah A. O'Neill. Paola Palacios Gonzalez. Jack L. Palmer. Kennedy Paldo. Chandler Presley. Jayla Quinn. Nijah Reese. Kiana Rogers. Shelby Rogers. Arkiria J. Scott. Arthur K. Screws. Talmicia A. C. Symphony S. Shaw. Raven D. Sherrod. Brianna Simmons. Charlie Spear. Hallie H. Spikes. Kiambra Stevenson. Quincy Stroman. Madeline Talent. Terrence Toussaint. Ashley Trammell. Kieria White. Deshala Wilkins. Amber Elise Williams. Janicia Wooten. Carrie Close, cum laude. Rihanna Fort. Taya Mercer, summa cum laude. Vishwa Patel. Kamaja Ross. Jaquan T. Timmons. Seth Love, cum laude. Carly Stapleton. Shannon Hart. Freedom Ray. Martavius Trey Carroll. Janique K. Davis. Gwynique Roundtree. Antonio Lamont Smith.
By the authority vested in me by the Chancellor and the Board of Regents of the University System of Georgia, I confer upon you a degree from East Georgia State College with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereunto. Graduates, it is a long-standing tradition that after receiving a degree or certificate, the cap tassel is shifted from the right side to the left side of the cap. This signifies to all the completion of a degree. Graduates, please move your tassels. Ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, I present to you the Fall 2020 graduating class of East Georgia State College. Graduates, from wherever you are celebrating today, raise the roof. Graduates, your family and friends who helped and supported you as you earned your East Georgia State College degree have extended their congratulations to you. Whether you send them a text right now or give them a fist bump, it is fitting that you recognize them for the support they have given you. Many of the remarkable faculty and staff who led you on the educational journey you completed today have joined us virtually to honor you as well. Please make a bit of time today to send your thoughts and thanks to them, even though we cannot all be together today. Today is the final graduation for Joyce Bomer and me at East Georgia State College. We extend to each of you our sincere and heartfelt thanks for allowing us to be part of this special community for the last 8 years. You will remain in our hearts forever. Due to the vision and generosity of members of this community, East Georgia State College was formed just about 47 years ago to provide a direct point of access to an affordable, high-quality, and personal college education for all of the amazing students of this region. Since that time, there has always been a special relationship between this college and the community it serves. So many of you have studied here and entrusted your children and grandchildren to us as students. Thank you for placing that confidence in us and allowing us to be part of this special college community relationship. Joyce and I have so many memories to take with us to Oregon, where we will join our daughters, Megan and Beth, our son-in-law, Steve, and our grandsons, Mason and Robbie. Thanks to all of you for these special memories. We will always cherish memories of hosting students at our home for taco dinners and having the privilege of talking with them about their hopes and dreams for their bright futures. Relaxing at the end of a long week during a first Friday at the Morgan House and listening to the music of our talented family, staff, and community members. Attending Vision Series events, thanks to the vision and generosity of Jean and Jimmy Morgan. Attending intense basketball, softball, and baseball games at the college's beautiful athletic facilities. Talking with high school students in gymnasiums and auditoriums across the region about the challenging but promising future awaiting them. Meeting with Correll scholars in their classrooms, thanks to the generosity and vision of Pete and Ada Lee Correll, and being inspired by the potential of these Correll scholars. Witnessing the strongest legislative delegation in Georgia as they regularly attended college events and steadfastly supported the college under the Gold Dome. Chatting with Luck Gambrell and Senator David Gambrell about their infectious love for the college, its students, and this community. The list goes on and on. Thank you all for allowing us to be part of your lives. Finally, Joyce and I ask you to join us in opening your arms to Dr. Don Cartee. As we take our leave, we know the college is in good hands. If you visit the Pacific Northwest in the future, it's easy to find us. Go west from the Portland airport until you hit the Pacific Ocean. We'll be there. Look forward to seeing all of you soon. Megan and Morgan Bryant will now conclude the ceremony with the singing of the East Georgia State College alma mater. I hope all of the graduates and their families and supporters will join us in singing from wherever you are celebrating with us today. The words are on your screen.
In the heart of Eastern Georgia, neath the pines of green, proudly stands our alma mater, noble and serene. Lift a chorus to East Georgia, let her grace be told. Glory to our alma mater, held to green and gold. May thy triumphs, dear East Georgia, ever be proclaimed. May thy loyal sons and daughters magnify thy name. Lift the chorus to East Georgia, let her grace be told. Glory to our alma mater, held to green and gold. Through the years of time swift passing, we shall ever be one with thee, our alma mater, one with EGSC. Lift the chorus to East Georgia, let her grace be told.